Okay students, from this chapter the next very important concept is hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide is H2O2. Hydrogen peroxide preparation methods and chemical properties and structure, those all things we need to discuss, and is very important also. This concept is very important for objective exams, NEET and JEE examination compulsory. They are asking some of the objective questions from this concept only. Preparation methods are as well as chemical properties of hydrogen peroxide. They are asking the questions from this chapter. Okay, students. First, we will discuss about the preparation methods of hydrogen peroxide. H2O2 preparation methods we will discuss. Okay, ma. First preparation method. Let's see, from hydrated barium peroxide. Hydrated barium peroxide molecular formula is BaO2. BaO2 means barium peroxide. It combined with water molecules is known as hydrated barium peroxide. This hydrated barium peroxide reacts with diluted sulfuric acid. Diluted sulfuric acid forms hydrogen peroxide. So this reaction is carried out at 0 degree centigrade. So equation, if you are after that, BaO2 barium peroxide. Okay, barium oxidation state is +2. And O2 oxidation state is -2. Each oxygen atom oxidation number is -1. O -2 means it will be like this. O, -1, and -1. -1 oxidation state is present in peroxides. Okay, students, barium peroxide molecular formula is BaO2. Barium peroxide is combining with water molecules is known as hydrated barium peroxide. Already types of hydrates we are discussing. So this is one type of hydrate. This hydrate, barium peroxide hydrate, is on treated with diluted sulfuric acid, then forms barium and sulfate ions. 2H+ and SO4-2. This SO4-2 and Ba+2 to form barium sulfate precipitate. And another product is H2O2. These two hydrogen atoms and peroxide ions combined to give H2O2. Hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide. The students, hydrogen peroxide is formed, H2O2. And another product is byproduct is barium sulfate and water molecules are formed. So the first method is hydrated barium peroxide. Hydrated barium peroxide reacts with diluted sulfuric acid, forms hydrogen peroxide. Okay. Next method is electrolytic process. The next one is electrolytic process. Let's see. This is very important. In this electrolytic process, how we are preparing H2O2, hydrogen peroxide. See here, the 50% H2SO4 is on electrolysis. 50% H2SO4 is on electrolysis, forms H2 hydrogen gas at cathode, and peroxydisulfuric acid H2S2O8. H2S2O8 is known as peroxydisulfuric acid. H2S2O8 is formed at anode. This H2S2O8 on further hydrolysis, H2S2O8 is on further hydrolysis forms H2O. Forms hydrogen peroxide. So in electrolytic process, the electrolyte is H2SO4. 50% of H2SO4 is on electrolysis. Initially forms hydrogen gas at cathode, and H2S2O8 peroxydisulfuric acid. H2S2O8 is known as peroxydisulfuric acid. Is formed at anode. This H2S2O8 is on further hydrolysis, forms hydrogen peroxide. So finally we are getting hydrogen peroxide. How much percentage we are getting in this process? 30% of H2O O2, hydrogen peroxide only getting 50% of H2SO4. Sorry, H2SO4 is on electrolysis. We are getting 30% of H2O2, hydrogen peroxide. We are getting. Let's see the equations. First, ionization. Let's see that ionization of electrolyte. Ionization equation. Electrolyte is sulfuric acid. The sulfuric acid will be ionized to give 2 moles of sulfuric acid. You have to take. It produces 2H plus ions plus HSO4 minus. Because if it is completely ionized to produce 2H plus ions. But diluted sulfuric acid we are taking, then it is produces H plus and HSO4 minus. Like that it will be partially ionized. Now the positive ions goes to cathode and negative ions goes to anode. At anode oxidation takes place by loss of electrons. These 2 moles of HSO4 minus undergoes oxidation to produce H2S2A. Disulfuric acid H2S2A will form and releases 2 electrons. These 2 electrons are accepted by 2H plus ions upon reduction at cathode to produce hydrogen gas. At cathode 2H plus accepting 2 electrons to produce hydrogen gas, H2 gas. Now, at cathode and anode products are formed. At anode product is peroxydisulfuric acid. This peroxydisulfuric acid is on further hydrolysis. Hydrolysis of H2S2O8. Let's see that H2S2O8 is on hydrolysis. Means reaction with water. H2S2O8 is on hydrolysis reaction with water to produce H2O2. Hydrogen peroxide plus 2 moles of sulfuric acid, H2SO4. This is our final equation. Okay, students, let's see the structure of peroxydisulfuric acid. The structure of peroxydisulfuric acid. If you observe that H2S2O8, it is a sulfur oxy acid. H2S2O8 is a sulfur oxy acid. In second layer, in 16th group element, sulfur oxy acids will learn. Different types of sulfur oxy acids, their structures, their oxidation states, those all will come in second phase. Just you have to remember, H2S2O8 is known as peroxydisulfuric acid, is also known as Marshall acid. Common name is Marshall acid. Now its structure, if you remember that sulfur, 2 sulfur atoms connected by a peroxy bond. Already the structure we have discussed in oxidation states calculation that time I gave. Each sulfur atoms are connected by the peroxy bonds. The middle 2 oxygen atoms are connected by the single bond in their oxidation states is -1 and -1. Now it is on hydrolysis. 2 moles of water you have to take, then this bond will be breaks, and here hydrogen and OH, and here hydrogen atom and OH forms. Means OH bond, yes, double bond O, OH. Means it is converted into H2SO4. And it is again H bond O, H plus H2SO4 forms. Like, that's why peroxydisulfuric acid H2S2O8 is on hydrolysis. Is on hydrolysis. The products are H2O2 plus 2 moles of sulfuric acid. So the finally we are getting hydrogen peroxide. That hydrogen peroxide is formed from the electrolysis of 50% H2SO4 or 50% sulfuric acid. First, that 50% sulfuric acid is on electrolysis forms peroxydisulfuric acid at anode and hydrogen gas at cathode. This peroxydisulfuric acid is on further hydrolysis producing hydrogen peroxide. This is the second method for the preparation of H2O2. This method is known as electrolytic process. Electrolytic process. Okay, students. I hope you understood, everyone. It is very, very important for board examination. For board exam, this concept, this preparation method is very, very important. Okay. Let's see the third preparation method. The third one, auto oxidation process, means the oxidation is taking place in the presence of atmospheric air. The oxidation is taking place in the presence of atmospheric air is known as auto oxidation process. Okay, students. So here, which compound is oxidized very easily in the presence of atmospheric air, that we need to discuss. Okay, students, the third method is auto oxidation process or auto oxidation method. Okay, now listen carefully. In the auto oxidation method or auto oxidation process, the reactant is the reactant structure. Remember, everyone, three benzene rings are connected like this. It is called as anthracene. Okay, anthracene. If they having at middle benzene having two OH groups are present, then it is called as phenol, anthraquinone. And here one methyl substrate is present, C2H5, then the numbering will comes like this. One, for this three benzene rings are connected like this, then the numbering we have starts from always here. One and two, three, four, up to the year four. Next again this 5, 6, 7, 8, next 9 and 10, next 11, 12, 13, 14, like that numbering will comes. So it is the starting one, means one and two ethyl position is two. So its name is 2-ethyl-anthraquinone. 2-ethyl-anthraquinone. Okay, students. Its name is 2-ethyl-anthraquinone, phenol. OH group is present, 2H group, that's it is called 2-ethyl-anthraquinone. This 2-ethyl-anthraquinone is on oxidation in the presence of atmospheric air. Oxidation in the presence of atmospheric air. In the presence of atmospheric air to form this OH groups will be oxidized. These two OH groups will be oxidized to produce these two hydrogen atoms. And this in atmospheric air, O2 is present to form H2O2, hydrogen peroxide. And this another important product is C2H5, 2-ethyl-anthraquinone. So here the products are H2O2 hydrogen peroxide its name is 2-ethyl
anthraquinone.
So triethyl anthraquinone, OH group.
OH is called over. C double bond group is called on.
So triethyl anthraquinone is on auto oxidation in the presence of atmospheric air to form hydrogen peroxide. H2O2 and another product is triethyl anthraquinone. This reaction, reverse reaction also we can take. This triethyl anthraquinone is stable and it is unstable. That's why it is easily oxidized in the presence of atmospheric air to form hydrogen peroxide and triethyl anthraquinone. Now, the question is, this triethyl anthraquinone is on reduction in the presence of hydrogen gas and nickel. Reduction to produce triethyl anthraquinone. This is on reduction. Triethyl anthraquinone is on reduction in the presence of hydrogen gas and nickel catalyst to form triethyl anthraquinone. This triethyl anthraquinone is unstable. Is unstable, can be oxidized. Can be oxidized. Oxidation. Can be oxidized in the presence of atmospheric air to form hydrogen peroxide, again to give triethyl anthraquinone. Again this triethyl anthraquinone, again you have to do reduction, then we'll get the triethyl anthraquinone will get. Triethyl anthraquinone, it will be unstable, it can be oxidized in the presence of atmospheric air to form hydrogen peroxide. So that's why this process is known as auto-oxidation process. So in auto-oxidation process, remember everyone, dear students, in auto-oxidation process, how we are preparing hydrogen peroxide. The hydrogen peroxide is formed from 2-ethyl anthraquinone. 2-ethyl anthraquinone is on oxidation in the presence of atmospheric air. Because it is unstable means it immediately catches oxygen gas from atmospheric air. Then this hydrogen will be combined, hydrogens are coming outside. Removing of hydrogen means oxidation only, na? It oxidizes to give 2-ethyl anthraquinone and hydrogen peroxide is formed. So ultimately we are getting hydrogen peroxide. That's why this method is named as auto-oxidation process or auto-oxidation method. Auto-oxidation process or auto-oxidation method. Okay, students, these are the three important preparation methods of hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide, H2O2. Okay, let's see. Hydrogen peroxide storage. How to store this hydrogen peroxide? Hydrogen peroxide, is it stable? This hydrogen peroxide is unstable. Storage. How to store this hydrogen peroxide compound? Hydrogen peroxide is a liquid. Okay, hydrogen peroxide is a liquid. It is unstable. Okay, it is unstable in alkaline medium. Alkaline medium and sunlight. It is unstable in alkaline medium and in the presence of sunlight. That's why H2O2, whenever it is exposed to sunlight, and to form water. to form water and oxygen. It is converted into H2O and O2 because it is unstable in the presence of sunlight. RN is also unstable in alkaline medium. That's why how to store the hydrogen peroxide. Therefore, this hydrogen peroxide, it is stored in plastic bottles. It is stored in a plastic, black color plastic bottles. Already I think in our chemistry lab, hydrogen peroxide bottles are present 30% weight by volume. So if you update that bottle, black color plastic bottle is in black color because the black color is not absorbed sunlight. Means that's why in black color plastic bottles we have to store. Otherwise, wax lined means wax. A thick material, the wax is lined on the glass bottles. Wax lined glass bottles. Glass bottles we have to store. Okay, hydrogen peroxide is stored in plastic bottles or wax lined glass bottles. Why? Means because it is unstable in the presence of sunlight or unstable in alkaline medium. And urea is, urea, small amount of urea is added to H2O2, hydrogen peroxide, because urea is stabilizer. Urea is a stabilizer. Okay, urea stabilizes hydrogen peroxide. That's why a small amount of urea is added to H2O2, and this hydrogen peroxide is stored in plastic, either in plastic bottles or wax lined glass bottles only, not in normal glass bottles or not in normal beakers. Okay students, outside we don't keep that hydrogen peroxide, we don't expose into the sunlight. If you are exposed into the sunlight, always we have to keep it in dark places only. If you are exposed to the sunlight, then it becomes water and oxygen because it is unstable. That's why the storage of hydrogen peroxide, mainly it is stored in either plastic bottles or wax lined glass bottles in dark medium. Dark only, not in a sunlight. Okay students, this is about storage of hydrogen peroxide. Let's see the chemical properties of hydrogen peroxide. Chemical properties of hydrogen peroxide. Let's see chemical properties. Chemical properties. If you update that hydrogen peroxide, H2O2. Is on decomposed to produce H2O and O2. And once you are aware that changing the oxidation states of oxygen in H2O2, oxidation state of each oxygen atom is -1, but in water molecule oxidation state is -2, and in O2 0. See here, the oxidation state is -1 to 0, means it is increased, then it is called as oxidation. In this oxidation process, it acts as a reducing agent. Itself undergoes oxidation very easily, means it acts as a reducing agent. Next, if you look at this H2O2 decomposed to produce water molecule. In this oxidation state, it changes from -1 to -2. Means oxidation number is decreased, means it is reduction. This reduction process, it acts as oxidizing agent. Means H2O2 acts as oxidizing agent, it oxidizes to another substance, it converts into water. H2O2 acts as a reducing agent, it reduces to another substance, it converted into O2. Okay students, so H2O2 chemical properties means it acts as an oxidizing agent as well as it acts as a reducing agent. This is a one important chemical properties. First and second. Along with that, this H2O2 also acts as a good bleaching agent. H2O2 acts as a good bleaching agent. And fourth one, it is a weak acid. H2O2 is a weak acid. So the chemical properties of H2O2 hydrogen peroxide, mainly we need to discuss about oxidizing properties of H2O2 and reducing properties of H2O2 and bleaching nature or bleaching agent or bleaching properties of H2O2 and weak acidic properties we need to discuss. So these are the main important chemical properties. Let's see the oxidizing properties of H2O2. First one, oxidizing properties. First, the oxidizing properties, first one, H2O2 oxidizes PbS. This is the black color. Lead sulfide always in black color. If we get a lead sulfide, when react with H2O2, the oxidize, H2O2 oxidizes lead sulfide into lead sulfate, PbSO4. This PbSO4 is a white color. Let's see the equation. PbS plus H2O2 converted into PbSO4. See here, four oxygen atoms are required. That four oxygen atoms are coming from H2O2. That's why four moles you have to take. Then one mole means one mole of PbS oxidized by using four moles of H2O2 produce one mole of lead sulfate and gives four water molecules. Okay, students. So H2O2 oxidizes PbS into PbSO4. Very, very important. The second chemical property is this H2O2 oxidizes ferrous sulfate in acidic medium, ferrous sulfate into ferric sulfate, Fe2SO4 thrice. Ferrous sulfate, iron in plus 2 oxidation state converted into iron plus 3. Ferrous sulfate into ferric sulfate. Let's see the equation. That reaction is carried out in acidic medium. The reaction is carried out in an acidic medium. So ferrous sulfate FeSO4. Acidic medium means you have to take dilute H2SO4 and H2O2 hydrogen peroxide. So here the ferrous sulfate into ferric sulfate Fe2SO4 thrice. See, two moles of iron is present. Here two iron atoms are present, means you have to take two moles of FeSO4. Now, then the product is two moles, then it is converted into Fe2SO4 thrice. Here two sulfate ions and here one, three. Next, here two hydrogens and here two, total four, then two H2O. Ferrous sulfate is converted into ferric sulfate. This is ferrous sulfate. Into ferric sulfate. Means iron plus 2 is converted into iron plus 3. Means oxidation state increased, means it is oxidation reaction. Means ferrous sulfate oxidized into ferric sulfate. In the presence of, means that oxidizing reaction is due to that H2O2. Because the H2O2 acts as oxidizing agent, it oxidizes ferrous sulfate into ferric sulfate in acidic medium. In acidic medium. Okay, students. Next, manganese Mn plus 2 is converted into MnO2, manganese in plus 4 oxidation state in basic medium. In basic medium. Let's see this equation. Mn plus 2
In basic medium means OH minus ions reacts with H2O2 to form MnO2.
Manganese dioxide, MnO2 is formed.
See here, two units positive charge is present, that's why two units OH minus ions are taken. Then total charge will becomes neutral. Then Mn plus 2 is converted into MnO2, manganese dioxide. And the remaining H2O2 reduced into H2O,
water molecule. It
reduces H2O2, oxidizes Mn plus 2 into MnO2 and itself reduced into water. This is another important oxidizing property of H2O2. Let's see one more important oxidizing property. H2O2 sodium nitrite NaNO2 oxidized into NaNO3. Let's see the equation. Sodium nitrite is on oxidation with H2O2 hydrogen peroxide converted into sodium nitrate NaNO3 plus H2O. Okay students, let's see another equation. It's oxidizes potassium iodide, means Ki, into iodine. Let's see the equation. Ki, 2 moles of Ki reacts with H2O2. In Ki, potassium iodide, iodine oxidation state is -1 and is converted into iodine 0. -1 is increased to 0, means it is oxidation reaction. That oxidation takes place in the presence of H2O2. Then 2 forms I2 plus 2KOH. 2KOH is formed. Okay, students. Let's see one more important oxidizing property. It oxidizes H2S hydrogen sulfide. In H2S means sulfur oxidation state is -2 into sulfur. Sulfur oxidation state is sulfides into sulfur.
Sulfides into sulfur. Iodide is I minus into I2.
So sulfides, S minus 2 means H2S reacts with H2O2 to form S plus 2H2O.
See, it is balanced.